How are you putting guardrails in place to ensure that they're following your development philosophies?
Do you mean the athletes or our coaches?
The coaches.
Well, the coaches, again, we are, it's through communication. That sounds so simplistic, but it is through communication and relationships. I mean, as I said, I have an MBA, but I'm a master of social work. I think I use my social work degree way more than my MBA every single day in life, because all of us are just simply humans. And so we have these incredible private coaches across the country who have done, you know, a lot of wonderful, wonderful work. And I feel that Tennis Canada, yes, we definitely need to have guidelines, we definitely need to have standards, but it is in conjunction with the private coaches that we need to create and develop those standards and then work with them in terms of the implementation of those standards. And I don't know that that was exactly the philosophy when I arrived. We also had a little bit of an issue with our provincial tennis associations. And for me, we adopted the exact same approach. It is about communication, it's about relationships, it's about involving all of those stakeholders in the process, as opposed to Tennis Canada coming from on high to dictate to the country how this is going to work. So it has to be two-way. It's how I live my life, it's how I run every business I've run, and I actually think we made some good progress over my years there.